Hey folks, Serena McKnight here with Cycle World, and what I have here is the 2021 Honda Rebel 300. Now, this motorcycle is the epitome of beginner cruisers. Started off with its introduction in 1985 and has since been bringing new riders to the sport. So it's powered by a 286cc liquid-cooled single-cylinder engine, and that engine lives up to its beginner friendliness. But overall, the engine delivers its power very smoothly, very approachably. It's definitely geared towards that beginner. It revs quick, but is not quick to intimidate. It has 25 horsepower at 7,640 RPM and 17.6 pound-feet of torque at 7,320 RPM. Now, when you get into the twisties, you can really rail this machine around. You use all the power on the freeway, so it still gives you a little bit of extra space to get around traffic and have some fun on it. Now with this engine, you could run it a gear high and it doesn't chug or stutter, you still have that power available. It also has a slipper and assist clutch, which offers a very light clutch pull. Moving on to suspension, it has a 41 millimeter telescopic fork and dual shocks in the rear. Both of these are on the firmer side, but when you get into those twisties, the overall weight is carried down really low. We measured it to be 372 pounds, so you could really flick it into each of the turns with confidence. Now, smaller bumps are dealt with very well. However, the rear does bottom out with its 3.8 inches of travel when you hit those hard bumps. Now, for stopping power, it stops with Nissan calipers and a 296 millimeter disc in the front and 240 millimeter disc in the back. I have plenty of feel at both the lever and the pedal. It stops on a dime, and this braking system is really great for this size of motorcycle. We also tested its braking performance, and it stops from 60 to 0 in 141.3 feet, which is pretty impressive for this little machine. And ever since its introduction, the Honda Rebel has been known for its extremely low seat height. We measured it at 27.34 inches, and that is incredibly low to the ground. I always find myself kicking my leg up way higher than needed. When you sit down, you're nice and low, plenty of bend at the knee. Now, in regards to ergonomics though, the pegs do put your knees, my knees at least, a little higher than is super comfortable with that seat being as low as it is, and your arms are outstretched in front of you. It is comfortable for about an hour and a half ride, but that seat is firm, so you do start to feel a little numbness there. We also had some feedback from a shorter rider who's 5'6", 31 inch inseam, and he agreed that the ergonomic feel is the same. Your knees are a little higher up and the seat is low with your arms outstretched. Now, Honda's fit and finish is very great for its price range. You have a very clean, minimalist look with this motorcycle. A couple of the letdowns is that it has plastic paneling and the plastic front fender and only two colorway choices to choose from. However, you have a full LED lighting package, beefier bobber look with the fatter tire and the 2.95 gallon peanut tank dropping down to that solo saddle. And overall, the whole package looks very clean and modern. Our test unit is priced at $4,899. Now that's with ABS. You could also opt for a non-ABS version, which is $300 less. For 2021, there are no new changes because it did see some changes back in 2020, but there is a $100 price increase. Overall, with Honda's Rebel, what you have is a beginner-friendly motorcycle. You have that quick revving engine, the confidence-inspiring braking package, and a firm suspension and chassis feel that allows you to have fun in the twisties with a clean fit and finish, all for a low entry-level price. Now that's it for this first ride review of Honda's Rebel 300. If you liked what you saw, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.